we go out and we talk to a lot of network engineers. I know you guys aren't all network engineers, but we talk to them all the time, right? It's our core business. And we ask them, you know, what are you doing for automation? Like, how are you interfacing with the people who are trying to automate everything that you do as a tech org, you know, wherever you're at? And most of them, like 90% of them, tell us that they'd love to do that, that they know it's, you know, something they got to pick up, but almost none of them are actually engaged in doing that yet. And we feel like, you know, cloud is having such a huge impact on the way we develop products and the way we deliver our products to our customers. We have to bring our core demographic, network engineers, up with us, right? And to get them to start interfacing with and start having meaningful impact on people who are trying to automate tech processes. So we have put together, this is actually a personal, Matt Oswalt and I, this is our main function here at Juniper. We put together a program called NRE Labs. There's a sticker, I think we handed out stickers for it. You can go to labs.networkreliability.engineering, and if you are a network engineer or you know network engineers that you think should, you know, you want to help them, you know, move along this path, please send them there. It's a site designed to teach automation and DevOps stuff to network engineers who don't know anything about it. And it's hopefully going to be a central point where network engineers can go do this, and we can sort of bring the whole network engineering community along for the ride.
We did actually show NRE Labs in some detail at Networking Field Day 20. So you'll see Matt Oswalt's familiar face if you go look at those videos, or if you want to share other people, share those videos with other folks if you want to learn more about NRE Labs. We are just 5 minutes before the end, so I did want to bring all of our speakers back up, our presenters back up, in case we had any last Q&A before we wrap up and hand things back off to Ken.
Just a comment on your last statement about NRE, and I think that's a great initiative, but my experience with network engineers is they're the last person, because of this kind of reluctance and dealing and whatever the history is, that to understand and know the problems that the business and the application teams are experiencing and what they need to kind of deploy in the network. So I would say you kind of need to be approaching those guys as well, like with what something like Contrail can solve from an application perspective and a business problem perspective, not necessarily the, because approaching the network guys, they're just, you won't kind of break through to what actual the application teams are experiencing with problems. They just, in my experience, in my company, they just will not know what is going on at that level. They're just not interfacing at that level.
Yeah, so we actually target both sets of people. Nick talks to a lot of people who are not network engineers, right? This is another way cloud is changing the way network companies do things. Like a lot of our demographic now, when we go and talk about Contrail, it's not just the network engineers. It's application developers, people who manage cloud infrastructure, et cetera. We have to address the whole range. So Matt and I are reaching out to network engineers directly. People like Nick, our CSO team, for instance, the HD base team. There's a big list, actually. They're actually reaching out to people who aren't just network engineers, right? And trying to, the whole thing has to happen, right? The whole range of engineering talent in an org has to be a plan for all of them, and we are doing that. So,
I'm going to give you a pass on the just network engineers bit, but we tend to find ourselves in weird situations because from a lot of the cloud focused teams, we'll talk to application owners, like Derick said, and then eventually there'll be network people or systems people brought into the room. And you can almost see this like look of comfort cross their face when we start talking in understandable or familiar terms. The hardest part for us is actually up-leveling and talking to the application owners and building those bridges into parts of the organization where we as a network-focused company haven't really had a good presence.
So if I could, I'd love to hear your thoughts more on this in what time we have left, because I think this is, you know, the cloud is collapsing these job definitions, right? And the ideal state is that many of these titles don't exist, right? You have an integrated team. That's the DevOps concept, right? You have an integrated team. So how do you deal with network engineers who perceive this as an existential threat? I mean, you guys are very close to them. What do you tell them?
I'll tell you what we used to tell them. It's crazy. We used to say things like, if you don't learn how, you need to be the first person to buy into this new concept, because if you don't, someone else will, and you're going to lose your job. We actually used to market that way to network engineers, and it turns out people don't like being told that they're useless now.
Right.
And also, that's just not true. I mean, look how SDN actually unfolded. Network engineers are still around, still doing the same thing. Now they have more to do, right? With the whole point of network reliability engineering is to be realistic about network automation. And the number one thing that's required for NRE to be like a network reliability engineering practice to be successful is network engineers. We sort of need their expertise. They're not going to be obsolete. They're just going to be way more effective at what they do when they retool and rethink how they do networking. And they're going to have to. They're going to be using tools like Contrail and our Contrail Security Orchestrator. They're going to be talking to network equipment in plain English, right? They're not going to have to memorize 10,000 pages of books with all of the syntax and all the bits and bytes of every field, so they can be an IE level certificate holder, right?
Level 99 internet sorcerer.
Yeah, exactly. The whole world is changing, and they're going to have to change with it. But their expertise is still needed. Networks are still complicated, right? There's a lot of stuff out there, and we need them to come along for the ride.
So just a quick follow-up. Do you see that happening in a specific vertical or industry or a situation where that's happened? I've only seen it happen once or twice in my own experience, and I don't know if there's a pattern that you've seen.
Yeah, so it is becoming more and more relevant. Like I said, we still go out, and sometimes I've been in rooms of 60 people and asked, does anyone have an automation practice where that's test-driven and you're using GitHub? And 60 people were in that room, and not one raised their hand. But in other places, like in the service provider realm, a lot of software as a service type companies, it's way more common for them to raise their hand and to say, "Oh yeah, we do that. You know, we the elements in our network that need to be configured or whatever, whenever we're doing a rollout or building a sandbox for all of that, is they have all that down and it's all test driven."
So the one part I wanted to jump in, actually two things I wanted to jump in on real quick. If you look at any Kubernetes user experience, almost there's always top two concerns is either networking or security. Just flip them around, right? So networking is perceived as hard by application owners, which means there's an ask, right? Make the networking understandable, make it consumable by application owners. This is why we're seeing things like those custom resource definitions making their way into Kubernetes to control things like network parameters. That the default answer from the cloud native community in the past has been not our concern. Somebody else deals with that. What we've done is we've brought high-level interfaces into the application orchestrator so that they can state preference about the way they want their network primitives to function. That gets passed to the orchestrator. And then you see someone who has a knowledge of application but an expertise in networking implementing that request.
Yeah. Oh, NRE, actually, the term NRE, Network Reliability Engineering, Juniper did not coin that. Our customers did. And we found that by accident looking at job listings. We were thinking about what kind of things are companies looking for, and we thought we should look at job listings and see what skills they're asking for. And we found multiple customers, not one, but multiple customers at cloud companies, at telco companies, they had job listings for network reliability engineers. So it's definitely the gap between app people and network people is closing, for sure.
And I think efforts like NRE Labs, as we expand on that, will help folks get more familiar in a consequence-free environment that they can get up and running quickly. It's that perception of the bit. I think I'm stealing something you said yesterday, Matt, but it's the perception of the size of that initial barrier. That's what slows you down. It's not how long it takes you to learn something. It's how long you stare at that pile of books, that set of webinars saying, that's too hard, I can't do that, to taking that first step. Because we all know that once we start attacking the material and spend the time. We've all demonstrated that we can absorb complex topics, right? It's just we hold ourselves back because of that perception of complexity.